In this video, we're going to do page 41 in your lab books, which is the Introduction to Goal Seek activity. And I'm going to show you how to use Goal Seek. And Goal Seek is one of those tools in Excel that it might be a little confusing the first time or two you see it, but it's fantastic. Once you figure it out, it will save you so much time and energy and frustration. And we will be using Goal Seek a lot in this section, and then even more when we get to Unit 4 at the end of this semester. So the reason we use Goal Seek is if it's We use it when we're trying to solve an exponential equation. So say we have the equation maybe 12 equals 5 times 1 plus 0.2 to the x. So we know the output of the equation is equal to 5, and we're trying to solve for the input x. Well, you can't do this like you would a linear equation. If you divided 5 by both sides, which would be a good place to start, you would still have 12 equals 1.2 raised to the x, and you can't solve that and get x by itself without logarithms. And logarithms are a pre-calc topic. We don't do them in this class. So instead, anytime we need to solve an exponential equation, we're going to use Goal Seek. So let's look at an example in your lab book. Again, this is the Introduction to Goal Seek activity. So it says, in the town of Echelon, there's a single high school that can accommodate a maximum of 600 students under crowded conditions. They know from looking at population trends that the student population can be modeled by P equals 242 times 1.045 to the T, where P is student population and T is time in years since 1994. If this growth trend continues, when do they need to have a new high school ready? So they need to have a high school ready when it reaches its maximum. Its maximum is 600 students. So that's the population of the high school. We would put the 600 in place of P, so we'd have 600 equals 242 times 1.045 to the T. And again, we cannot solve that by hand without logarithms, so we're going to use Goal Seek. So it says in A2, type years since 1994. I'm going to make that wider so it all fits. And then in A3, type students. So we're just setting up a chart here. So we don't know the number of years it's been. That's what we're trying to solve for. That's T. For students, we can represent it by our equation. The students is our population. So let's put that formula in. We're going to put 242 times, and again, you have to have a multiplication sign in between a parenthesis, or before a parenthesis, otherwise Excel doesn't know what you want it to do. So 242 times 1.045 raised to, and instead of typing T, let's cell reference what's representing T. T is representing the year since 1994, so let's go up and cell reference the cell that's going to represent year since 1994. And put that in. And again, we're always going to put the formula for our dependent variable, and then it's going to solve the equation to tell us what our independent is to make the dependent whatever we want it to equal. So the way we solve this, once we've got it set up, again, this little chart, I'm going to outline it just so it's very clear. We have our independent labeled, but we don't know what it is. We have our dependent, and we put the formula in for the dependent. So start by clicking on the cell with the formula you just typed in. Go up to Data, over to What If Analysis, and then choose Goal Seek. So set cell, that should be your cell with the equation. I'm not going to do anything with it since I was already clicked in the cell with my equation. So we want to set the equation to what value? Well, we want this equation to equal 600. 600 is what we're trying to get to. So we're going to set our equation to the value 600. And then by changing cell, that's our input. What Excel's going to do is it's going to take this equation and basically guess and check a bunch of different input values until it gets to the one that's as close to 600 as possible. It uses a fancy method. I think it probably uses Newton's method. But what you'll need to know is Excel's going to do a fancy guess and check, trying out a bunch of different years until it comes up with a year that gets the output of the equation as close as possible to 600. So again, we're setting the cell with our equation to the value 600 by changing the number of years, and then click OK twice. And so this tells us 20.63 years after 1994. So basically in, let's see, 20 years later, that would be 2014. So 2014.63, just keeping our decimals, we're going to have 600 students. That's how we would interpret that. So 20 years later, 20.63 years later, there will be 600 students in this high school, and they need to build a new school. So let's try the two more examples at the bottom of this page. So again, bottom of the Introduction to Goal Seek page in your lab books. So it says Voldemir's savings account balance B can be modeled by the equation B equals 1250 times 1.025 to the T, where T is years since 2005. When will his balance reach $10,000? So again, we know our balance. Let's just set that equal to 10,000. We're trying to solve for T. It's asking when will we get there? So anytime we're dealing with time, that's almost always our input. So it's years since 2005, and that's going to give us the balance of the equation. The balance depends on how long the money's been in the bank. So for our output, our dependent, we type in our formula. Equals 1250 times 1.025 raised to, and then cell reference time, which is years since 2005. Then we click on the cell with the formula, go up to Data, What If Analysis, Goal Seek, and we want that equation to equal $10,000, and it's going to do it by guessing and checking a bunch of different values for time. So we're setting our equation to $10,000 by changing the number of years. And then OK twice. And so this tells us that 84.21 years later, he will have $10,000. That's not a good retirement plan. Basically, when you're old in life, you need more than $10,000. So he needs to come up with a different bank account. But looking at this, this is an exponential form. It's 1.025. That tells us that our interest rate is 2.5%. That's really low. You can probably get more like 10 or 12% if you shop around. So come up with a different bank. All right, last example for Goal Seek in this set. Again, bottom of the Goal Seek activity. Number two, it says the population of rabbits on an island with no predators can be modeled by P, which is 7 times 1.45 to the T, where T is months since they're introduced. So time determines the bunnies, their reproduction. So this will be months and then population. And it says, how long will it take it to reach 100? So 100 bunnies, that's our population. So that means we want our equation to equal 100. We can't solve that without logarithms. So beside population, we put in our formula. Population is given by 7 times 1.45 to the T. Again, use a cell reference. Then click on your equation, Data, What If Analysis, Goal Seek. We want to set our equation that tells us population to 100. And we're going to do it by varying the number of months. So it's going to take 7.16 months to get 100 bunnies. So those bunnies are doing a lot of reproduction.